Major General Agha Masood Akram, the Director General of the Defense Export Promotion Organization, I welcome you all to the 9th in this series of very prestigious events. Ladies and gentlemen, the first International Defense Exhibition and Seminar was held in November the year 2000 in this very venue at the Karachi Expo Center. And once again, it's a proud privilege to welcome you all to the city of Karachi and be hosting this very important, significant defense exhibition and seminar. At the very first exhibition, back in the year 2000, 125 Pakistani and foreign defense companies participated. Pakistan was honored to host 35 delegations from 20 countries of the world. With its basic theme, For Arms, For Peace, IDEAS has grown in size and in stature over the years. But never before has this theme been more relevant. Ladies and gentlemen, today's global security environment is the most unpredictable that you and I can recall in our lifetime. It is marked by complexity and rapid change. Global disorder has significantly increased, while some of our comparative military advantage will be continually challenged in the days to come. We as global citizens face multiple security challenges, and Pakistan indeed can speak from our own history and present-day environment. It is safe to forecast, and perhaps the only certainty that lays ahead is that the future of conflicts is rather grim. They will come more rapidly, they will last longer, and they take place on a much more technically challenging battlefield. Arms for Peace envisions and draws our attention to the question of the hour. It envisions to engage some of the most brilliant minds in this very arena through this next 3 to 4 days of dialogue, of exhibitions, of meetings, and it will bring home the very question how to employ our military and security forces to prevent conflict and to protect the humanitarian interest around the globe. Ladies and gentlemen, IDEAS for Peace calls for greater agility, innovation, and integration. I must apprise you that this year we have a big show, and indeed there are so many things to look forward to. First, there are 418 firms from 34 countries participating, out of which 157 are Pakistani firms. This time, 9 more countries are visiting and participating in IDEAS. These include Luxembourg, Denmark, Belarus, Poland, the Czech Republic, Switzerland, Belgium, Romania, and Nigeria. We welcome all our distinguished guests, and to proceed forward, without any further ado, may I now take the opportunity to invite Major General Agha Masood Akram, the Director General of Defense Export Promotion Organization, to deliver his welcome address.
Honorable Prime Minister, delegates, excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, Assalamu alaikum and good morning. On behalf of Defense Export Promotion Organization, I extend a warm welcome to our distinguished guests. We, the organizers of IDEAS 2016, feel fortunate to receive our esteemed guests from 55 countries. Prime Minister, we are grateful to you for gracing this occasion and extending your patronage to the organization and our efforts in organizing IDEAS 2016. Your kind support is a source of inspiration to us to work for standards par excellence. The International Defense Exhibition and Seminar, short titled IDEAS, has come a long way and progressed with a fast pace since its inception in the year 2000. Presently, IDEAS has achieved the status of one of the major defense exhibitions in the region. Ladies and gentlemen, IDEAS is a platform for convergence of international and domestic defense exhibitors, security analysts, and high-level policy makers for creation of new opportunities of mutual cooperation in the field of defense. we are pleased to announce that IDEAS is booked to its full capacity of space available in the Expo Center with a total of 418 foreign and Pakistani exhibitors and companies besides trade visitors. We are also hosting 90 defense delegations from 43 countries representing all continents of the globe. Among our foreign friends, you have already heard the list of the 9 new countries who have joined us, and we welcome them. With the patronage of our government and guidance of the Ministry of Defense Production, we are in the process of constant improvement. The very new efforts for IDEAS 2016 include enhancement of space by addition of new halls 7 and 8 due to overwhelming response from the international and domestic community. Participation of leading chambers of commerce from all over Pakistan as desired by the Prime Minister during last IDEAS. Engagement with the private sector has facilitated public-private partnerships in defense promotion and export. Gala dinner and cultural show to display the rich culture of Pakistan. Sideline conferences on the venue where stakeholders will get ample opportunity to share their interests and business concerns. Ladies and gentlemen, last but not least, I have here the people and organizations without whose support and cooperation we could not have achieved this memorable event. I would like to thank the Armed Forces of Pakistan, the Ministry of Defense Production, Governor Sindh, Chief Minister Sindh, the Ministry of Commerce, Ministry of Finance, Ministry of Interior, the Ministry of Information and Broadcasting, Trade Development Authority of Pakistan, the defense industry, both public and private sector, Civil Aviation Authority, the Sindh Rangers, and Karachi Police for their wholehearted support and contribution towards creating an enabling environment for the planning and conduct of this event. I would also like to pay tribute to the people of Karachi for their all-out support and their patience with us. Profound thanks to my small team of officers and men drawn from Pakistan Army, Pakistan Navy, and Pakistan Air Force, who form the Defense Export Promotion Organization, DEPO, which I am honored to head. Thanks and appreciation are due to our event manager, Badar Expo Solutions, for putting up a very professional show, fielding a competent team, and effectively marketing IDEAS 2016 worldwide. I would again like to express my gratitude to the Prime Minister and all our noteworthy guests for participating in IDEAS 2016. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. And here I must once again mention that Pakistan will proudly be presenting the indigenously developed defense products to be showcased here at IDEAS 2016. This includes the main battle tank Al-Khalid, JF-17 Thunder fighter aircraft, KD aircraft Super Mushak, fast attack craft missile boat, UAVs, armored personnel carriers, premium grade military hardware and related technology. But what is technology without insights? I think Pakistan in this entire scenario has much more to offer as our own experience fighting the state and the non-state and the hybrid conflicts. Ladies and gentlemen, may I now take this opportunity to invite the Federal Minister for Defense Production, Mr. Rana Tanveer Hussain, to please say a few words.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Honorable Prime Minister Mian Mohammad Nawaz Sharif, Defense Minister Khwaja Mohammad Asif, Chief Minister Hussain Murad Ali Shah Sahib, and Aga Masood, the DG Depot, Excellencies, respected delegates, ladies and gentlemen, Assalamu alaikum and good morning. On behalf of Ministry of Defense Production Pakistan, we are indeed indebted to you for gracing this occasion and extending your patronage to my ministry and our efforts in organizing Ideas 2016. Your kind support is a source of inspiration for us to work for the highest standards. I am also grateful to the worthy guests from participating countries, respectable ambassadors, high commissioners, defense attachés, foreign and domestic exhibitors, the actual mobilizing force to make Ideas a success. I also welcome warmly all those who have joined us for the first time and my profound regards to all old friends. I assure you that it is you who makes this event successful. Ladies and gentlemen, Ideas is a biannually held international event organized by DEPO with a view to showcase a wide variety of modern and conventional defense equipments. The event draws a diversified audience, including diplomats, senior government officials, defense ministers, armed forces hierarchy, defense sector experts, executives, and international local media, to name but few. It also provides an opportunity for local defense industry to proudly showcase the prowess in producing high quality defense products at par with developed nations. It is instrumental in sharing our hard-earned knowledge of defense sector in the form of mutually beneficial partnership and joint ventures. I am certain that Ideas 2016 will provide lucrative opportunities to Pakistan's defense industry, parallel industries and affiliated businesses locally, and of foreign countries to help achieve more viable business prospects than ever before. Ideas stands for its slogan, Arms for Peace, and I believe that it is through the right use of arms that we can curtail violence in any shape, nationally and internationally. Without any doubt, we all aspire to see our world free of violence, and progress in defense industry can be one of the major sources for this dream to come true. Ladies and gentlemen, here I would like to appreciate dedicated efforts displayed by DEPO in organizing this splendid occasion of Ideas 2016. DEPO has surely been successful in providing such a rich and rewarding platform to a large number of countries around the globe. Besides conducting Ideas, it acts as a one-window national platform for promotion, facilitation, and coordination of export defense-related products from Pakistan, thus providing an opportunity for Pakistan to coordinate and work closely with other friendly countries in established defense-related businesses. Through this opportunity, I encourage all stakeholders to make use of DEPO platform for enhancing defense exports. In the end, before concluding my views, Mr. Prime Minister, I would like to express that during the era of present government, under your kind guidance and vision, the defense industry of Pakistan has progressed much more and recognized internationally. Thus, this all is done due to your personal interest. We are proud of that. As and when we requested you, your good self, for anything, you have very kindly helped us. Therefore, me and my team is thankful to you for being here and grace the occasion by your presence. Thank you very much. Pakistan, Pindabad.
Thank you, sir. And indeed, Pakistan is keen on maintaining the comparative advantage over our traditional areas of military might and at the same time offering a lot to this dialogue and discussion. Under the dynamic leadership of the Honorable Prime Minister, Pakistan, of course, is keen on being the deterrent, denying and defeating in state conflicts. And of course, when it comes to the other non-state actors, disrupt, degrade and defeating them. Along with, of course, strengthening the global networks of allies and partners, many of whom are, of course, present in our August gathering today. Ladies and gentlemen, may I now take this proud privilege to request the Honorable Chief Guest, the Honorable Prime Minister of the Islamic Republic of Pakistan, His Excellency Muhammad Nawaz Sharif, to address this August gathering.
Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Sayyid Murad Ali Shah, Chief Minister Sindh, Rana Tanveer Hussain, Minister for Defence Production, Khwaja Muhammad Asif, Minister for Defence, Services Chiefs, Excellencies, Major General Agha Masood Akram, DG Depot, distinguished guests from brotherly countries, ladies and gentlemen, it gives me immense pleasure to be here and have the privilege of witnessing the IDEAS 2016. I thank the organizers for inviting me to this event. I would like to extend a warm welcome to all the distinguished guests on the occasion of the opening ceremony of IDEAS 2016. The presence of a large number of foreign delegates and participants is extremely encouraging. I appreciate the efforts of the organizers for making IDEAS 2016 such a successful event. This exhibition is a reflection of the excellence and professionalism acquired by Pakistan's defense industry over the years and the sense of commitment demonstrated by all those associated with it. Ladies and gentlemen, our government is focused on turning around the economy and improving the human capital by investing in the social sectors. Pakistan is blessed with a young and vibrant population with a rapidly growing consumer demand. Pakistan today offers enormous opportunities for profitable investment, joint ventures, and trade in all sectors of the economy, including the defense industry. Let me give you a snapshot of some of the key economic benchmarks and indicators in Pakistan today. Monetary policy announced by the State Bank of Pakistan in May 2016 reduced the discount rate to its lowest level in the last 40 years. The inflation is anchored well below 3%, which is lowest in 47 years. Upgradation of Pakistan index to emerging market index is an important development, not only for Pakistan, but for the entire region. Pakistan's economy is back on upward growth trajectory, and financial year 2015-16 saw growth of 4.71%, the highest in the decade. Our GDP is expected to grow well over 5%, inshallah, in 2016-2017. Tax to GDP ratio has increased to 12.5%, which is up from 9% when the government introduced its economic reform agenda. Jim O'Neill of Goldman Sachs has included Pakistan in N11 or Next 11 group of economies expected to register rapid growth over the next decade. Ladies and gentlemen, international credit rating agencies, international finance institutions acclaimed analysts and well-reputed economic journalists, economic journals have all praised and appreciated the important strides that we have made over the past 3.5 years in turning around Pakistan's economy. Both Standard and Poor, as well as Moody's, have upgraded Pakistan's credit rating from stable to positive. Fitch has also assigned a stable rating to Pakistan. The improved security environment in Pakistan, with last year being the lowest in terms of terrorist incidents, has already generated a lot of business interest and enthusiasm for investment. Another major constraint holding back the economic revival and growth was the severe energy shortages in Pakistan. Due to a comprehensive strategy adopted by the government, the energy supply has greatly improved and is expected to reach optimum level as we operationalize some of the key power projects in various stages of implementation across Pakistan. There is no load shedding for industrial sector for the last 12 months, while domestic and commercial sectors will also be rid of this menace by start of 2018. Ladies and gentlemen, being a firm believer in the private sector's pivotal role in the economic development of Pakistan, our government has framed policies aimed at providing an enabling environment for private, local and foreign businesses to thrive. Our investment policy provides one of the most liberal investment regimes in the region, allowing 100% foreign ownership with emphasis on reducing costs and processes involved in doing business and creating linkages for trade and industry. We also have numerous attractive investment opportunities and the power, oil and gas information technology, infrastructure, consumer goods, financial services and capital market sectors in Pakistan. IDEAS has attained global recognition over a period of time, and the exhibition is increasingly recognized for showcasing innovative technologies which are unique and exclusive. A vast array of more than 2,000 weapon systems and equipment are on display today. It also reflects the broad-based participation of Pakistan's public and private sectors in defense production and export, supported by research and development, expansion in production capacities, and intimate academia-industry relationship. Ladies and gentlemen, Pakistan's quest to develop our defense industry is in close cooperation with international community, and IDEAS 2016 demonstrates results of collaboration of local and foreign technologies. These efforts have resulted in first achieving self-reliance in defense production and opening up for exports. Pakistan remains committed to discourage any arms race in the region. We in fact pursue the motive of arms for peace, which is always the tagline of IDEAS. Dear guests, I would like to congratulate the Defense Export Promotion Organization and the Ministry of Defense Production for organizing IDEAS 2016 in a befitting manner and sharing the technological know-how of Pakistan's defense industry with the international community. I will also compliment DEPO's efforts, especially for the promotion of public-private partnership in defense production. I am equally happy to witness the growth of Pakistan's defense industry and wholehearted participation of armed forces of Pakistan and a large number of government organizations. I also appreciate the support provided by the Ministry of Commerce and strongly desire it shall further encourage the growing private sector defense industry of Pakistan. Ladies and gentlemen, I am pleased to share with you that defense products of Pakistan are state of the art and stand fully tested by our own armed forces. Our defense products have made their mark in many countries of the world. However, there are still many opportunities for further growth and exploration of new markets. The showcasing of Pakistani products and their recognition in the international market has proved the claims of quality with affordability, which is a landmark of our defense products. Seminar 2016 is an integral part of ideas which will be held this evening. It will facilitate better understanding of the views of eminent foreign as well as Pakistani scholars and political scientists on very important issues of economics of regional peace. I am confident that the seminar will enable a better understanding of mutual interest and will be fruitful for regional peace. I am confident that the discussions there will explore the way forward for peace and stability in the world in general and our region in particular. I also appreciate the organization of sideline conferences during Ideas 2016, which will facilitate exchanging technologies for mutual benefits and bringing together buyers and sellers, which is one of the core objectives of our defense exhibitions. Ladies and gentlemen, Pakistan is fast emerging producer of quality defense products. The promise of today's Pakistan is brighter and reassuring than ever before. Taking this opportunity, I invite you to seize the moment and expand business links with Pakistan. Thank you all. Pakistan Paindabad.
This opportunity to request General Rahil Sharif, the Chief of Army Staff, Admiral Mohammad Zakaullah, the Chief of Naval Staff, Air Chief Marshal Suhail Aman, the Chief of Air Staff, to kindly also proceed towards the stage and join us for the formal inaugural of Ideas 2016.
تینوں مسلح افواج کے سربراہان اس وقت اسٹیج پر موجود ہے اور تقریب کا باقاعدہ افتتاح ہونے جا رہا ہے. مناظر آپ 92 نیوز کی سکرین پر دیکھ سکتے ہیں کہ وزیر اعظم میاں محمد نواز شریف، وزیر دفاع خواجہ آصف سمیت وزیر اعلی سندھ سید مراد علی شاہ بھی موجود ہیں. اور اب اس دفاعی نمائش آئیڈیاز 2016 کا باقاعدہ افتتاح ہونے جا رہا ہے. وزیر اعظم، وزیر دفاع اور تینوں مسلح افواج کے سربراہان اس وقت اسٹیج پہ موجود ہیں اور تقریب کا باقاعدہ افتتاح ہونے جا رہا ہے.
Ladies and gentlemen, this marks the official opening of the 9th International Defense Seminar and Exhibition. The Ideas 2016 is now open. With this, ladies and gentlemen, the Honorable Chief Guest will proceed to witness the exhibition.
ایکسپو سینٹر میں دفاعی نمائش آئیڈیاز 2016 کا باقاعدہ افتتاح ہو گیا. وزیر اعظم میاں محمد نواز شریف نے باقاعدہ افتتاح کیا، جس کے مناظر بھی آپ کو دکھائے گئے. اور نمائش میں 43 ممالک کے 90 وفود شرکت کر رہے ہیں، اور ان میں سے 30 مندوبین اعلیٰ سطح کے ہیں، جن کی سربراہی ان ملکوں کے وزیر دفاع، ڈیفینس سیریٹرز، چیف ڈیفینس سٹاف یا حاضر چیف خود کریں گے. مجموعی طور پر 261 غیر ملکی اور 157 پاکستانی کمپنیاں شریک ہوں گی، جبکہ 34 ممالک کی 418 कंपनियां नुमाइश में अपनी मसनूआत पेश करेंगी। इसके साथ ही साथ आपको ये भी बताएं कि सिक्योरिटी के इंतहाई सख्त इंतजाम किए गए हैं। प्लान के मुताबिक रैपिड रिस्पॉन्स फोर्स की 4 कंपनियां भी अतराफ के इलाके में सिक्योरिटी के फ्राइज सर अंजाम दे रही हैं। सिविक सेंटर के अतराफ सड़कें ट्रैफिक के लिए बंद कर दी गई हैं, जबकि शहरियों को मुतबादिल रास्ता अख्तियार करने की हिदायत की गई हैं। और 2000 में अब से पहले इस नुमाइश का इफ्तिताह किया गया था और अब की नुमाइश गुज़िश्ता नुमाइश से 9 गुना ज़्यादा बड़ी बताई जा रही है। और इसके साथ ही साथ आपको ये भी बताएं कि दिफाई नुमाइश का सिक्योरिटी प्लान भी तरतीब दे दिया गया है। नुमाइश में वज़ीर आज़म मियाँ मोहम्मद नवाज शरीफ, आर्मी चीफ जनरल राहील शरीफ और वज़ीर दिफा वज़ीर अला सिंध, एयर चीफ और नेवल चीफ भी मौजूद थे। इसके साथ साथ DG रेंजर्स बिलाल अकबर भी नुमाइश में मौजूद थे। नुमाइश के मनाज़िर आप 92 न्यूज़ की स्क्रीन पर देख सकते हैं। वज़ीर आज़म मियाँ मोहम्मद नवाज शरीफ ने नुमाइश का बाकायदा इफ्तिताह किया। सुपर मशाक K-8 एयरक्राफ्ट, फास्ट अटैक क्राफ्ट, मिसाइल बूट्स इस नुमाइश का हिस्सा बने हैं और एक्सपो सेंटर कराची का ये मनाजिर है। वज़ीर आज़म मियाँ मोहम्मद नवाज शरीफ ने से कुछ देर पहले इस तकरीब से खिताब भी किया और उन्होंने कहा कि पाकिस्तान को खुशी है कि वो अपने दिफाई शोबे में आगे बढ़ रहा है और अब की नुमाइश गुज़िश्ता नुमाइश से 9 गुना बड़ी बताई गई है। एक्सपो सेंटर कराची के ये मनाजिर हैं। दिफाई नुमाइश 2016 का बाकायदा इफ्तिताह कर दिया गया है और आपको ये भी बताते चलें कि सुपर मशाक के 8 एयरक्राफ्ट, फास्ट अटैक क्राफ्ट, मिसाइल्स बूट्स भी इस नुमाइश का हिस्सा हैं। तो नुमाइश का बाकायदा इफ्तिताह वज़ीर आज़म मियाँ मोहम्मद नवाज शरीफ ने किया और 261 गैर मुल्की और 157 पाकिस्तानी कंपनियां शरीक हुई हैं इसमें, जबकि 34 ममालिक की 418 कंपनियां अपनी मसनूआत पेश करेगी। इसके अलावा रूस के 3 इदारे ऐसे हैं जिन्होंने इसमें शिरकत की है और पहली दफ़ा ऐसा हुआ है कि रूस के साथ साथ हॉलैंड के भी 3 इदारे ऐसे हैं जिन्होंने इस नुमाइश में शिरकत की है। और आपको ये भी बताएं कि सिक्योरिटी के हवाले से अगर बात की जाए तो रैपिड रिस्पॉन्स फोर्स की 4 कंपनियां भी अतराफ के इलाके में सिक्योरिटी के फराज सर अंजाम दे रही हैं। सिक्योरिटी इंतहाई सख्त बताई गई है और नुमाइश में 33 ममालिक से 90 वफूद शिरकत कर रहे हैं और इनमें 30 मंदूबैन आला सतह के हैं जिनकी सरबराही उन मुल्कों के वजीर दिफा, डिफेंस सर्वेटर्स, चीफ डिफेंस स्टाफ या हाजिर चीफ खुद करेंगे। अभी ये नुमाइश के मनाजिर हैं और इस नुमाइश का इफ्तिताह वजीर आज़म मियाँ मोहम्मद नवाज शरीफ ने किया है और अब वो नुमाइश का दौरा कर रहे हैं, मुख्तलिफ स्टॉल्स का दौरा कर रहे हैं। नुमाइश में रखे गए तमाम जो तैयारे हैं, तमाम सुपर मशाक तैयारे और जितनी भी ये चीज़ें हैं उनका ये दौरा कर रहे हैं, जिसके मनासिर आप 92 न्यूज़ की स्क्रीन पर देख सकते हैं।
कराची एक्सपो सेंटर में दिफाई नुमाइडियाज 2016 का इफ्तिताह वज़ीर आज़म मियाँ मोहम्मद नवाज शरीफ ने किया है। ये मनाजिर भी आप देख सकते हैं। वज़ीर आज़म मियाँ मोहम्मद नवाज शरीफ के हमरा चीफ ऑफ आर्मी स्टाफ जनरल राहील शरीफ भी मौजूद हैं और जो स्टॉल्स लगाए गए हैं मुख्तलिफ कंपनियों की जानिब से उनका दौरा किया जा रहा है। उनके साथ जो वक्त भी मौजूद है उनकी जानिब से